People will notice that the longer we go, we keep loading a lot more scriptable objects, so that means we need to be adding them on the resource manager or having a way to hold all of them. And that takes time. And that makes us also having to drag and drop things. Okay, so that means a lot of repetitive tasks. Well, thankfully, programming is all about repetitive tasks and alleviating the pain of doing them. So let's create a few utilities. Well, just only one, actually. So I'm going to say editor utility. And actually, no, I'm going to rename this to editor utilities. And I'm going to also put a space in there just for fun. And then we're going to create a new script, which is going to be also called editor utilities, but this time no space, of course. Okay, close that. And here's the trick. This is we're going to be using this only on the editor. So we're going to drop this under utilities. And over here, I'm going to make this a static class. So that means it's not a mono behavior and we can't use any of these things in here. Okay. I also want to do, I don't want to include any of this inside the build because we're going to include the Unity editor namespace. So what I'm going to say is if Unity editor, you can use this. And of course, and if. So, what do we need? We're going to return a list of, we just need to get all types of assets from, we say we want all our scriptable objects that are of T type. Okay, we're going to write a method that is going to return us, it's going to look onto the folder we are passing, and it's going to return us that, it's going to return us any object that has that type. So, T, find assets by type, pass the T, and type of T, where T is a Unity engine, not Unity, Unity engine dot object. Okay. The objects we're going to be getting are going to be objects from the Unity engine. Don't confuse this with object with C sharp objects. Okay, they are slightly different. So, list. Let's call this assets. We're going to have a new list, and we have a GUI IDs, which is basically the instance ID for anything inside Unity. And we're going to be utilizing Unity's own asset database, find assets, string.format, where T, if this looks like it's alien to you, that's because it's really it's kind of the internal stuff and how you find this basically googling. Okay, so you might remember this, or it might remind you. If you write T over here and say texture, you get the type all textures you have, all the assets you have over here. Okay, so what do we do over here? We essentially did the same thing. We get the same type of the one we are passing. So, continuing on, for its GUI IDs.length, we have in here, we're going to need the asset path, GUI ID to asset path, GUI ID, I, actually GUI IDs, I, T, let's called this asset. Asset database. Load asset at path. T. Asset path. Okay, so if asset is not equals null, that means we do have our asset, and that means assets dot add the actual asset. And finally, return assets. Okay, so we can utilize this to actually get back all the assets of type what we are passing. Okay, so where is this utilized? Of course, it's going to be utilized onto the resources manager. Okay, and here's something we're going to do. We're going to say void. Actually, you know what? These now are arrays, so they're not really going to play that well with what we just wrote. So let's turn them into lists. Okay. Public list. Oh, come on. Okay, so the result, of course, with this, we now need to change to count instead of length. Let's find it everywhere. There it is, okay. We do have one more, I believe. Count. And down here, count. And, of course, count. Okay, and we turn that all to lists. So, now, we're going to add a new hook down here and say if Unity Editor and if. Okay, so it's not really going to be searching for assets if this is a build, because, yeah, it cannot. It cannot do that. So, this is going to be returning us what we write on the editor utilities is going to be returning a list. That means all I have to do is say all weapons will now be editor. Let's say dot utilities dot editor utilities dot find assets of type. The asset of type I want to get is of course a weapon. Okay. And drop down here. Similarly, mesh containers equals SA dot utilities editor utilities find asset of type mesh container over here and character objects equals SA dot utilities editor utilities find assets of type character objects. And finally, masks. Masks are going to be masks equals say dot utilities dot editor utilities dot find assets of type. Yeah, I think we're going to have much more problem though, because masks are also character objects. So let's see. Yeah, we might need to make this a little bit. Actually, yeah, I don't think it's going to be a much of a problem. Anyway, this will populate our list. So, going back now into our resources manager. Let's see. resources manager. I'm here. Okay, I'm going to ignore all of this. I'm going to set everything back to 0, 0, and 0. Hit play. And you will see that they actually populated everything we have created inside the scripts are actually inside our resources manager as well. Okay, the only problem that we might have to fix later is that, as you can see, we kind of have the same value. Yeah, we kind of have both the character objects and the masks in here. Okay, yeah, this actually might not be a problem. Let's see what does on the main scene. And if we don't have a problem there, then we can just leave it like that. Okay, inventory. Let's see. Okay, everything is in here and it's one at a time. All right, same with the suits, same with the weapons, same with the pistols. Yeah, okay, so it works perfectly. Okay, we don't have any skills, so we're gonna utilize the same thing for our audio holders. Audio. Oh, come on. Audio holders. Okay, we do need an integer. Although we're just doing this for holding. Yeah, for now. And mostly for using it, you know. Sounds that we don't really necessarily need to have them upon a game object. We just need to call them once, play them, and they're be done. Okay, because we have that, let's see, init audio holders, and as usual for audio holders dot count if dict dot trying it contains, trying it contains key audio holders I dot name. Okay, throw debug log in there and say otherwise a dict dot trying it value audio holders I dot name and I. Oh, one more thing. Clear the dictionary first. Same with all the rest. We kind of forget to do this. Clear the dictionary as well. In here. Here. We are doing this in here. And we're doing this in here as well. So what did I just... Okay, this is the character. Object. The dictionary. Okay, drag this down here, we need audio holders, also audio holders equals say utilities, editor utilities, find assets by type, audio holder. Okay, awesome. So we also now include this type of assets. And this, the same list can work for anything really. It doesn't need to be just scriptable objects. It can work for any asset you have. If you want to load all your textures, for example, you can say public list textures. Actually, we might not even need to initialize them. Textures, say, utilities, editor utilities, Find assets by type, texture. Okay, this you don't write this. I'm just doing this to showcase it. Yeah. That didn't have to do with plotting the assets. It had to do I wrote it wrong. I wrote instead of other, I wrote get value, try to get value. Resource manager, okay. And if you want to have all your textures, well, it didn't work, but anyway, okay. And I think it didn't work because they are kind of, let's see. No, it should have worked. Probably the casting might have been wrong or something. Let's see, maybe if we initialize it. Let's try sprites then, instead of. Let's see if that's going to work. Huh. Good to know. Well, anyway, okay, I think it because it has to do with either we wrote something wrong or it might have to do with you know, the endings of those types. But anyway, it works perfectly for scriptables. I think, yeah, maybe this doesn't work because it doesn't get them as an asset. Although it should have taken them as a type. Anyway, doesn't matter. It works for the other things we want to have. Okay, for example, we have the scriptable objects, which we load. Fine. Now, the only thing that you need to be careful with this is that this actually, because it runs at runtime, as you can see, it has everything okay assigned. But before you do any builds, okay, you need to make sure that you have run the game at least once, and of course, you have all your list full in here. So for example, if we hit 0 and then load again, it's going to be loaded back. Okay, so run the game once, make sure the resource manager at least runs, and then you know, feel free to play the game and make as many as builds as you want. Okay, so let's end this video as well here. Okay, because yeah, it's just a concise encapsulated concept. So as always, you know what to do, like, subscribe, and if you like to see more, if you like for me to be able to keep making more, then consider supporting me either on Gumroad or via Patreon. Of course, with Patreon you also get access to the site, where you will be able to see the videos much earlier than when they're going live, and as well depending on the tier you are, you have additional rewards, for example downloading the scripts, the source code, and stuff like that. Well, mostly that, basically. And then we go with discount codes. Anyway, I'll see you next time.